Hosting packages and using packages, it's a vital part of DevOps. And guess what? You can do all of that using GitHub Actions. So join me and Aaron on the next DevOps Lab, where he's going to dive in and show us just how to do this. Welcome to the DevOps Lab. Today, we have a very special guest with us, Aaron Powell, and he's going to be showing us how to deploy packages with GitHub Actions. Welcome to the show, Aaron.
Thanks for having me back on.
Absolutely. Okay, first of all, can you tell my viewers what are packages and why should they care about them?
So for what we're talking about here, it's things like the libraries that you download from open source projects to use in the application you're building. Whether you're building a Node project and pulling something from NPM, .NET packages from NuGet, or Java packages from Maven, or wherever it might be, these are something that someone else has worked on, has contributed to, that's made it easy for you to consume. And you want to get that from some kind of centralized repository rather than having to go out and just like download raw source code yourself. So we want to talk a bit about how we can use those things in our application and how we can make it easier as a owner of an open source project to make them available for people.
Awesome. Okay. So basically packages work great for like shared code, right? So if I have like a shared library that the rest of people in my org uses, I can create a package and now they can have a versioned version of my package to use.
Precisely. And that's the whole point is that I want to make sure that it's easy for someone else to consume the thing that I've built. I've found it useful. I'm hoping someone else is finding it useful as well. So I want to make it available to them.
Yeah. So obviously I'm a DevOps guy, right? So I'm really interested in how can we automate all this? I would love to be able to create like a pipeline that would build my library, version it for me, and then I guess put it into some type of package management.
Yeah, and I reckon we're both on the same page with this one. I hate having to do manual steps of, I compiled it on my machine. Now I've got to upload it somewhere and make it available for people to use. I want to automate as much of that as possible. I'm cutting a new release of my library. I want to tag that in my Git repo. I want to push that tag up so that people know this is the source code that was used to ship that particular version. And I want some automated system to be able to take all of that, build it and get that available to you as someone that wants to consume it.
All right. So you've convinced me. This sounds awesome. Sounds super useful. How do we make this happen?
Well, the way that we're going to be using today is using GitHub Actions because, as an open source developer, one of the primary places I put my stuff is on GitHub. And GitHub Actions just makes it so easy to do this kind of task-based automation. It's right there in the repository. The workflows I'm building are in the repository as code. So it's all there. I think probably the best thing we can do is let's jump over to VS Code and have a look at how we can go about building a workflow that will cover this off. So this is from one of my open source projects that I've got, and I've got a couple of workflow files in here. One of them is used when I push to the primary branch, the main branch, or when pull requests come into the main branch. I want to build this code, make sure that tests pass, that it's conforming to my code style and standards and stuff like that. And then I want to get a package that can then be consumed by someone. If I'm working and like iterating on an idea and I'm pushing out potential new releases, I want to make sure that someone can grab that version of the package and test it without me having to go, here's version 1.2, and then it finds out that there's a pretty critical bug. I'd like to know that a bit beforehand. So that's what I'm doing here off the main branch. Also, if you're sending me a pull request, I want you to be able to grab that package so that you could incorporate it into your application, make sure that it works the way that you're expecting it to work without me, again, having to just assume that it's all correct, push a new version, only to find out that we got a rollback. So this is my GitHub Actions workflow. I've got a job in here that is going to do the build step. So this is for a Node package, but the pattern is still the same whether you're doing Node or .NET or Java or Python, or I could keep listing languages if I wanted to, but we're talking about a Node one in this particular case. So the build is going to go ahead and just run across a couple of different versions of Node and set up a matrix strategy. This is just because I want to test it in a few different scenarios. But the important thing is that I'm doing some standard node steps to create that package. I'm running npm CI, so this is going to download all my dependencies, and then I'm going to run npm lint, make sure that the code is conforming to my code formatting standards. And finally, I'm going to run a build step. This just makes sure that the TypeScript, this project is written in TypeScript, will be valid and it compiles down and all that sort of stuff. I haven't written any tests, I probably should, but you can see that I've got a comment in there that I've got to write some tests, and then you'd run like an npm test to do that. So fairly standard, build, test our package, make sure that, you know, at least the compile step works. But once that's done, well, how do we get that package delivered so that you can consume that app? Well, that's where I've got a second section in this workflow file. It's called package, so it's a separate set of steps that are going to happen. Once the build is successful, so assuming that it compiled and linted and all that thing, we can then do this. It will then grab the code out again. It's just running the same install packages build step, but then we're going to set up a new version. And this time we're going to take the GitHub run ID. So this is a environment variable that's provided by GitHub Actions. And I'm saying that I want to tag this release that's been built as a pre-release with CI-GitHub run ID. This just means that, well, because it's pushed to the master branch, or sorry, the main branch, I want to make sure that this is being, like, it's marked as a pre-release. It's not ready for you to use in production, but if you want to test out the bleeding edge, well, this is how you can grab it. And then finally, we run npm pack, which generates out our package that we would push up to npm, or in this case, we're actually going to push it to the GitHub packages registry. I don't want every single commit that I do to end up on npm, because most of them are probably just like testing and superfluous, you know, pushes. I don't need everything there, but I still want it available somewhere. So the package is there. We upload it as an artifact so that you can grab it and download it if you so desire. Or finally, we'll publish it to GitHub packages. So if you're not familiar with GitHub packages, it's like a package registry just like you get out of npm, out of NuGet.org, Docker, and like I said, a variety of different package repository platforms for different languages. But this is part of your GitHub repo, or sorry, your GitHub account. So I can push packages there that can then be consumed elsewhere. So I'm just saying that if I'm doing a test to make sure that, well, this did actually come from me, so a pull request won't try and publish a potentially malicious package. We're going to grab the artifact that we uploaded in the previous steps, and then we're going to say the registry that I'm going to publish to. So this is the npm registry. We would change this for NuGet, for example. It's going to be npm.pkg.github.com. And then we're going to finally do an npm publish, send that package up. Too easy. Now we've got a pre-release version of some changes that have been done available for anyone to download. Let's jump over to the browser and actually see what has happened for that to work. So in the GitHub Actions, I'll come into Node CI. So this is the one that that ran. Let's grab a passing one. We'll ignore the failing ones for the time being. And we can see there were three jobs. That's the build step, the package step, and finally publish to GitHub Action, GitHub Packages. We have an artifact down the bottom. If I was to download that, it's the TGZ file, so the package that was uploaded or would be uploaded to a package repository. But it also means that I could come back to, say, the code tab, and we can see that there's a new release available. And if I come into here, that's the package that was published for the a major release that was done. We've got a package here that was done as a CI build. So these are all the things that are available that I can download and use with inside of a project. And I can just use them the same way I was like at npm any other package that I have in my application.
Wow, this is awesome stuff. This is super cool. Like being able to host and deploy and use packages within your CI/CD pipeline, that's just good DevOps. And from the YAML that you showed, it's really pretty simple. There's already actions in place that just let you do all this, right?
Exactly. We're not using anything majorly customized because we're just doing things like, you know, command line operations like npm CI to install packages or npm run build because we want to build a package. And then these are the same things that you could be running on your local machine. And maybe you are. Maybe that's the way you're doing your packages at the moment. You're just doing those commands locally. But instead, we can push these up and have them automated by the runners with inside of GitHub Actions.
Yeah, this is super, super cool stuff. Packages, this is so incredibly useful, especially if you're dealing with like shared libraries, right? I hear people tell me all the time that they ask me, you know, how do you handle shared libraries? And I always tell them, use some type of package management, right? If you're in the C# world, you use NuGet. If you're in the Java world, use Maven, whatever, right? All languages have something, but this is fantastic stuff. Now, if you want to learn more about it, check out those links down below and join us next time on the DevOps Lab.